Welcome back to Let's Play Starfield Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari. This guy's not ready for us. We have to come back to him.
The data on this slate could very well be crucial. Lives could be at stake. Again, don't tell me how you got this slate from Emilio. I don't want to know. I couldn't have gotten this slate without your help. Thank you.
Well, so that's that. I guess we're going to go talk to Sarah. Who is this way? Now,
service with a smile.
I don't want to jinx anything, but I did not encounter any more stuttering. I ran around in here for like about 20 minutes. And there were no more stutters. So hopefully it's not a while I'm recording type of thing. So I'm just hoping it's something that went away on its own.
I hope you are satisfied with the quarters available to you.
How high can we jump with those? Yeah, should be able to do it, right? Wait. When I get close, I can't seem to do more than two. Alright, never mind then, I'll just...
I am at your service, Captain.
I just go up like a normal person. So I hope they'll just like take off or something, because then what's his name down there with the tree will be waiting for us quite a while. Wakey wakey.
Whenever you're up for it, we have work to do.
Work to do. Alright, so I've asked all this, I'm ready.
We're going to be doing some old-fashioned detective work. The artifacts are relatively inert once they're out of bedrock. That means people can pass them around, not even knowing what they are. I've been letting my contacts know to be on the lookout for strange metal objects. Get back a lot of noise, usually. But a tip from the UC Vanguard sounds promising.
Other people have artifacts? You know this?
We have to assume that we're not the only ones to have stumbled into this mystery.
It's assuming.
But most people aren't going into space looking for the unknown. They're looking for places to settle, resources to extract, territory to defend. An odd-looking rock or a single strange hunk of metal wouldn't mean much to them. That's why Constellation exists, in a way. To put pieces like this together.
Literally. Tell me about the UC Vanguard. Let's see what she might have to say.
A volunteer force that helps defend the edges of United Colonies space.
Oh.
They're always looking for recruits. Lots of retired veterans and dangerous professionals mixed in with part-timers who barely have a laser cannon welded to a hull. My contact is in the recruiting office, so he hears a lot about what the volunteers are up to.
Yeah, I guess they are volunteers. I didn't think of it that way, but... okay. Yeah. Good. A chance to learn more about the United Colonies, then.
Jumping to anthropology on me already? Oh, well, good. We all need our own reasons to be out there. But it's not just that. I want to take this opportunity to see how you handle yourself.
Oh, boy.
And for you to learn more about us. I'm going to be sticking with you for this. We'll be traveling together until we either find an artifact or this lead runs dry.
Sarah will be locked as your follower if you continue. Where's my other follower go? Back to the ship? Probably. What do I get out of this anyway? Does Constellation have a salary?
You mean besides the ship, the robot, and a place to stay all rent-free?
Well,
we do have some funds we can disperse from time to time. Not to mention, I think we can get you a proper suit. We're explorers. We keep a lot of equipment on hand for that purpose. So the more you work with us, the more we can share what we have.
Okay. I don't know. The only things I have to do are, like, to craft and modify an item. And wait for this guy with the tree. Let's go get that artifact, then.
We'll need to head to Mast. Check in with the Vanguard recruiting office where my contact works.
Okay.
And listen, whatever you were before, or whatever you do once you're out there, I don't care. So long as you don't bring UC security to our doorstep.
No promises.
Every member of Constellation is their own conscience. Understood.
So what do you mean exactly? You don't care if I steal as long as I don't get caught?
I mean, Constellation has a roster of members who haven't always been on the right side of their respective society. We're risk takers. Some of us have seen the inside of a jail cell more than once. If you join us, it means you're committed to our mission. In exchange, we give you latitude in your choice of means.
Sounds kind of reckless, though. I think an organization should have rules.
Those are the rules. Advance humanity's knowledge to the best of your ability. As long as you do that, I'm not here to judge you. Now, let's you and I get over to Mast.
Okay. Can't be dismissed until the old neighborhood is complete.
We need to talk to John Tuala in Mast.
How did you know there was an artifact on Victara?
You can thank Barrett for that, if he's still around to thank when this is all said and done. Honestly, he took this seriously before any of us. It was at his urging that we started doing deep space scans. I will admit, it was something of a shock to see Barrett taking anything seriously.
Well, he was really affected by his artifact. I guess, do you mind if I ask you some personal questions?
Not at all.
Oh, this is really the Spanish Inquisition here. Do you have any religious beliefs?
My parents considered themselves to be enlightened, but their lives were so busy they rarely pursued their beliefs. By the time I was old enough to start questioning these things, the idea of following any organized religion was almost an afterthought. It's not that I don't want to believe in anything. It's that my scientific mind is often at odds with my spiritual center. Having been out there, in the Starfield, seeing all those magnificent wonders with my own eyes, I need answers, not religious theory. I'm sorry if that disappoints you.
Not at all.
Don't worry. While we're on this journey together, I fully intend to respect your religious beliefs.
Well, that's good to know. There we go, smile. What do you consider your areas of expertise to be?
You mean, apart from being the chair of Constellation for the past 5 years?
Yes.
Well, let's see. I pride myself with my aptitude for astrodynamics, calculating optimal trajectories for grab jumping. That's been quite useful in the past. And as far as planetary exploration, my area of expertise is botany. So, don't worry. I won't let you eat anything that might put you in the hospital.
Well, that's always a good thing. Is there anything you like to do for fun besides exploring?
Exploration is my entire life. I consider it both a career and recreation.
Well, I said beside that.
That being said, I will make a confession. But you have to promise to keep it between us. Before I graduated from school, I was in a band. And no, I don't mean the school band. I mean a rock band.
Cool.
We called ourselves Ironic Comet. A ridiculous name, I know. But we were just a bunch of teenagers getting together and having fun. And before you ask, no, I wasn't the lead singer. I actually played the drums. The band never really went anywhere, of course, but those were good times, and I remember them fondly.
I would have picked you for more of a bassist. Well, I guess that's it, then.
I hope you got something out of that.
Interesting anecdotes. Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, and you're gonna follow me. Alright, so our friend over here, are you going away? Are you staying with us?
Captain, now that you are a member of Constellation, I am at your service. No additional protocols necessary. Also, given the likelihood that you will be out in unsettled space, it might be beneficial to go over exploration outpost development. In case you ever need to build a base for field research.
That's quite a while from now. Start an outpost on a planet. Okay, so he's not our follower, because we have this option. So what are you talking about, outpost development?
The exploration of an unknown planet can be a major undertaking. By building an outpost, you will be able to construct scanning equipment, resource extractors, and defenses. It is even possible to set up multiple outposts capable of manufacturing, allowing you to build advanced equipment.
What kind of advanced structures could I build?
The scan booster is the most obvious, as it will enable you to detect landmarks and other points of interest from further away. Beyond that, extractors will allow you to collect raw materials of various types, while fabricators enable the manufacturing. A particularly prosperous outpost may even warrant the construction of cargo links, allowing you to share resources between other outposts you have built.
How do I know if a planet has the resources I need?
A planetary scan will reveal the presence of key inorganic resources, although rarer elements will be harder to find without training. And while a scan may detect the presence on a planet, you will have to analyze the native plants and animals yourself to know what compounds they produce.
Okay. Wait, there are more questions.
I hope you are satisfied with the quarters available to you.
Forgive me if I asked these back in episode 2 or 3 or something. I don't remember. Do you miss Barrett?
My primary function has been to support and protect Barrett during his travels. I am currently unable to do so. That is as capable as I can be of missing anyone. I believe Barrett would find your question amusing.
Probably. Protecting Barrett must have been quite the challenge.
Barrett has, thus far, survived every mission on which we have embarked. It is therefore evident that my efforts have been successful. I suspect that Barrett would disagree with how necessary my intervention has been in any given situation.
Probably. How long have you been a part of Constellation?
I arrived along with many material goods purchased by the group's previous chair, Malcolm Livingstone. Despite several significant system replacements and upgrades, I have been online for 43 years.
Yeah, I just realized he has not been following me around. He's just been standing here anyway. Ever since I came in here, so I guess he's just gonna... I guess I'll find you here. See you, Vasco. Let's go, Sarah. Right. So we're going to MAST headquarters, where I have previously been.
Ever run into spaces?
Is that my heartbeat? I think it was the music. There's just one problem. It's under. Yes, I think that's part of the music. Yeah, I should not have gone up here, but it's under it, right? Will you follow me into fire and flame? Ah! Here she goes. I'll take the ramp. They're getting too all of here. Hello again.
Have some questions?
Yep. Maybe. Well, we had Constellation business to discuss.
All right. Here's what I've got. Vanguard volunteer by the name of Moera. Helps patrol the old neighborhood. Sol, Mars, Neptune, you know.
Sorry.
The Sol system. Which admiral did he upset to get that posting?
He's Martian, born and raised. Not like I can get anyone else to care. Word is he's got some fancy metal ornament he's been showing off to the old grounders. Matches that description Sarah gave me.
Wait, what's wrong with the Sol system?
You kidding? Lowest posting request rate in the whole fleet. Only thing there the UC cares about is Mars. And no one wants to go to Mars. They want to get off Mars.
Who's this Mora?
Oh, he goes way back. I think he was recruit number 81 or something.
If he's on patrol, he could be putting our item at risk, unless it's safely stashed away, I'm assuming.
What? Nah. Sol system is as quiet as a coffin. It'll be fine.
That means it's not going to be fine.
Nah.
I'm sure you two can handle it. Sol system is a lot of planets, but a vet like Moera will be checking in at Sidonia on the regular.
Moera.
You mean hitting the bars, don't you, John?
Hey, nothing wrong with a little refresh between patrols.
Did Moera say where he found this ornament of his?
You'll have to ask him. But Vanguard volunteers have retrieval rights if they get into a scrap. Wouldn't be surprised if he found it off of a pirate or something like that.
Bar in a spaceport, though, sounds like home.
It's definitely a lifestyle, burning helium out there, seeing where the stars take you. Displays in the orientation hall are all optional, but encouraged if you're not all that familiar with UC history.
Okay, I wanted to ask him more about Sidonia, but that is gone. So, we need to find Vanguard Moera, who might be in possession of an artifact. He was last seen patrolling the Sol system. So we really are just leaving this system. Oh, the other activities left. To make an item and stuff, those are gone, I think. Wait a second, activity. Oh no, they're here, I think. I hate to leave this undone. I might just rest and check in on him. Yeah, complete a research project, craft an item. Visit the Apollo landmark on Luna. Well, that'll be a good thing to do while we're there. Who's Sergeant Yoon? Down there? What are we... Why are we talking to Sergeant Yumi? Which way is down? Oh, is that after the... Wait a second. Wait, does it show... Oh, Nat Station. I don't remember who Sergeant Yumi is. Oh, is it just leading us? Is that the one we're supposed to... No, it's Moala or something. Morara?
I've flown across most of the settled systems in all manners of spacecraft, and yet I still get sick on the night.
I was supposed to talk to the sergeant here. I don't remember what it's about.
I wonder what the artist was trying to rip.
Why do I want to talk to you? Oh, to enlist. No, I'm not interested.
Sarah, good to see you. Listen, I smoothed over that incident between Mateo and Rosa at the Sanctum.
I'd hardly call it an incident. More of a debate, really. But I appreciate it just the same.
Not a problem. In the meantime, maybe you could tell him to take it down a notch.
Can do. Thanks again, Sergeant.
That was interesting.
Contrary to what you might have heard, UC security personnel are good people. And Sergeant Yumi just happens to be an old friend.
Okay, good to know. I just want the coordinates back. I'm just gonna go rest at the lodge and then see if we can help this guy. Oh, I guess that's not at the lodge. I just wanted to point us back there. I guess we can do that anywhere. The Constellation Mission Board, that'll bring us. And I did previously check that out, I just didn't take any mission from it. I just hate to leave here and then find that this guy's ready to talk to me and I'm like halfway across the galaxy.
Been a long time since I've been to Mars. The Sol system doesn't get a lot of traffic.
Yeah, so I've heard. Up there somewhere. See, you follow me to here, Sarah.
that we're here, perhaps we could spend a bit of time relaxing rather than planning.
I thought you were the one who wanted to go. Which one's my room again? Somewhere down here. Not the one with people in it. Is it this? Owned means that it's owned by someone else. My room. There's too many rooms here. I don't know which one's mine. Kidding me? This one doesn't say owned. One local hour. Really? It's equal to 2 hours and 5 minutes. Let's sleep for this a little over 8 hours then.
Get up and get going. We've got the stars to explore.
We gotta speak Kelton Frush. How do I get out of here? Here's the bar. Okay, just cut through here. Didn't want that to be out.
I am at your service, Captain.
Thank you. Goodbye. Alright, let's... Oh, I didn't select. Where are you? Greetings.
Oh. I was hoping we might run into one another again.
Yeah, something like that.
Your timing is most fortuitous.
Fortuitous?
I'm on the verge of something, but I don't quite have all the information I need.
You never seem to have all the information. If you're still paying, I'm still listening.
Well, actually, Mast would be paying, but I see your point and assure you that you will be compensated for your time.
Yeah, I assure you.
Of course, now that I understand more about what's going on, it seems plain as day. And yet, I never would have imagined it before.
Hmm.
The tertiary trunks have also liquefied their interiors, but they're not vibrating. I thought perhaps it was some sort of defect, but it's much simpler. They're listening.
Huh? I don't understand what that means.
It means it is ready to reproduce.
Oh.
I believe this tree is sending vibrations out over massive distances and expecting to detect sympathetic vibrations in return. As of yet, there's been no response. I suspect that will not change, that a response is impossible, and that's very, very bad news.
How would it reproduce? How would it reproduce by sending out vibrations? Like, would other trees just come over here and... We'd have a... Bow chicka wow wow. We... Define bad news.
We're continuing to see an increase in the strength and frequency of the vibrations. I don't know how much more significant it'll become. If there's no response, the tree may vibrate itself and some nearby portion of the city to destruction.
Oh my god.
Now, as of yet, there has been no response. And clearly, none of the nearby individuals are a correct match. While it can't be ruled out that the intended recipient of these messages was cut down during the city's expansion, there is one other possibility. Over 100 years ago, the United Colonies and the Freestar Collective emerged from the Narian War. As a gesture of peace and goodwill, a near-literal olive branch, one of the trees from New Atlantis, was offered to the leaders of Aquila City.
Huh. What a weird choice for a peace offering.
Certainly wouldn't have been my first suggestion. Something about the common roots of humanity or some such. Politicians and their metaphors. Of course you can't just uproot a native species and plunk it down on some other planet in a totally different environment and expect it to grow. Clearly no exobotanists were consulted ahead of time. The end result was wholly predictable. The tree died within a few short years.
So that's a dead end, pardon the pun?
Clever, but no, not necessarily. The tree died, yes, but branches were kept. At least one still exists in the museum there in the city. If I had that branch, I could get DNA samples, and then using various data I've gathered, I could attempt to simulate a response. We could then broadcast that response and hopefully calm down our friend here. But as I say, I need that branch.
And we finally arrived at the point.
I'm afraid I can't be two places at once, and I have too much going on here. The museum in Aquila City is under the supervision of one Miss Kassler, I'm told.
Kassler.
I don't know anything about her, but hopefully she'll be willing to listen to reason and assist our cause. All right, off you go. We don't have any time to waste.
Speak to Leah Kassler.
It's amazing to think that this tree predates New Atlantis. Can you imagine all the changes it's seen?
He just talks over. How is a tree branch supposed to help here, though?
Had I not explained that? Perhaps I wasn't clear. I have been rather agitated lately. Thanks to the large sample size of the data from my, colleague, I can use a generative algorithm keyed to the unique DNA and structure of an individual specimen. I can run simulations to attempt to replicate the physical characteristics of this other tree, and from that, derive an approximated audio profile of the tree's vibrations. Hopefully, our friend here will sense those vibrations, assume there is a suitable mate out there, and, well, calm down, I suppose.
How do they even meet? They send each other pollen or something? I don't know how that even works. It honestly sounds like you just made all that up right now.
I assure you, this is decades of expertise speaking.
Yeah, I assure you. You think it'll be difficult to get what I need?
Hard to say.
Probably.
As I mentioned, I have no personal knowledge of this woman who runs the museum. I did take it upon myself to send correspondence explaining our predicament, but there has been no response. I do hope she will appreciate our situation and be sympathetic. If she is not, well, as an official representative of MAST, I could never condone or even suggest that theft was a viable option. But...
Got it. We never had this conversation then. Wink.
We're still having it, of course. Ah, oh, but I get your meaning.
No, we didn't have it. Alright, so we got another thing. Another reason to leave the planet, so... Late bloomer. I need to go get the tree branch from Leah Kassler. Alright, well, I think we're gonna do the Constellation quest first. Is this the liquefaction you were talking about? I don't want to be standing under this. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.